learners, this is Elina Mishra. Welcome to Snape's Biology.
In the last part, we have already discussed different parts of the flower and some important terms which are associated with the flower. In this part, we will discuss about calyx and corolla. So, let's start. So, first we talk about the outermost hole of the flower, calyx. Individual members are known as sepals. So, if the sepals are green, they are called sepaloid, and if the sepals are colored, then they are called petaloid. Now, if these sepals are fused, then the condition is known as gamosepalous, and if they are free, then the condition is known as polysepalous. We would be using these terms when we explain a flower during the discussion of families. So, sepals can be free or they can be fused, and we have a way of representing it when it comes to the floral diagram. Clear? In floral diagram, a sepal is drawn with a pointed end like that present in the diagram. And suppose we have to show that these sepals are free, then we don't join the ends. But if we have to show that the sepals are fused, that is the condition is gamosepalous, then we make a loop like structure. So the first diagram would represent the free sepals, and this loop like structure, this would represent the fused sepals. And this is how we draw a sepal when we drawing a floral diagram. Now these sepals, they have a function to perform. The main basic function is to protect the flowers in bud condition. That means once the flower starts to open, this sepal's job is done. If the sepals fall off as soon as the flower or floral bud starts to open, we would give a term. So these are three terms which are given to these sepals on the basis of duration for which they remain on that flower. So first one is caducus. Caducus means the sepals fall off as soon as the buds start to open. That means here, as soon as the job is done, the structure is going to fall off. And this is seen in case of cactus, adzimum, papaver, etc. Next, the second condition is deciduous. Deciduous condition is the most common one. Every part of the flower has a specific role to play. Sepals have to protect the bud. Once their job is done, they should fall off. But if they remain and fall off along with other floral holes, like petals will fall off after the pollination is done, because their job is to attract the insects for pollination. So if these sepals are remain for a longer period of time, that means the flower has completely opened up, pollination has also taken place. Now the petals fall off, and along with that the sepals fall off. Then those kind of sepals are known as deciduous. And this is very common thing which is found in most of the flowers. The third condition is when the sepals remain attached even after the fruit is formed, then those sepals are known as persistent sepals. Persistent sepals are seen even attached to the fruit. For example, in brinjal, when we see the brinjal, there are this green structure which are still there. So those are actually the persistent sepals. We also see it in strawberries. Sepals are still there. So we find these sepals remain attached to the fruit in case of chilies also. So here we call them persistent sepals. That means even after the fruit formation has taken place, the sepals are going to remain there. Clear? So depending upon the duration for the sepals remain attached, three types are there. Now sepals may perform some additional function, so we would call it modifications of sepals. The first modification is when the sepals get modified into a structure called papus. This papus is a hair or tuft of hair which is found at the top of the fruit.
This would helps in dispersal of fruits. And this peppers is seen in Asteraceae family. That is, for example, sonkers, sunflower, etc. In sunflower, seeds dispersal is through peppers. And this peppers is nothing but the modified calyx. Okay. Next is where the sepals become leafy. So leafy structure is seen. The example of this is musanda. In this flower, the flower is normal, but one of these sepals become long and leafy. So here one sepal is modified into this leafy structure, and it is normally white in color, but because it appears leaf like we call this modification as leafy. Clear? The third modification is the sepals might become spiny. So we call this modification spinous. It is seen in case of trapa. In trapa, we find that these sepals, they become this two pointy structure, and there is the edible part. So those pointy structure which is there, so these are the nothing but the modified sepals. Sometimes the sepals are modified into hood-like structure. Thus, it covers the whole flower, which is seen in case of aconitum. Okay. Next, in the family of Lamiaceae, the calyx is bilabiate. That is, it is differentiated into an upper and a lower leaf. Each leaf is composed of one or more sepals. For example, Osimum. Here, there is one sepal in the upper leaf and four in the lower leaf. Next modification is spurred. When one or more sepals become beak like outgrowth called spur. Example, Delphinium. Okay. So we will discuss one more thing related to sepals after we are done with the petals or corolla, that is aestivation. Aestivation is the arrangement of the whole. How are these sepals arranged on the thalamus in a circular manner? And this aestivation is actually common for the both sepals and petals. That's why we discuss this aestivation after the discussion of corolla. Next comes to the second hole from the outside, that is corolla. So the next inner two sepals is corolla. The individual members, they are known as petals, and again, if the petals are fused, then the condition would be called gamopetalous, and if they are free, then the condition would be called polypetalous. Main function of corolla, because it is brightly colored, is to attract agencies for pollination. This is the primary function of corolla, and these agencies could be birds, insects, or animals. So they are brightly colored so that these agencies get attracted towards the flower. Clear? When we talk of corolla, there are various forms of corolla. So now we will discuss about the forms. First, we will discuss about the different forms of polypetalous corolla. The first one is known as cruciform corolla. Cruciform corolla is a characteristic feature of Crucifera family or Brassicaceae family. In this, the number of petals is 4. Each petal has two parts, a narrow part which is known as claw, and a broader part which is known as limb. And these two parts are arranged at right angle to each other. So this is how the arrangement is. Look at the diagram. 4 petals are there, and they are arranged in the form of a Greek cross. Greek cross is nothing but a cross sign. So petals would always arranged in the form of this Greek cross. That means if we draw the petals, these 4 petals would be like this. So this is how the petals arranged. So this is the Greek cross like arrangement, and every petals has to have these two parts. So when we see the flower of Brassica, then how is the flower visible to us? We find these sepals, and only this much is visible to us. The limb like structure is inside the tubular sepals, so only the petal parts, only the broader part is visible. example of this is Brassicaceae family members. Okay. The second type of corolla is caryophyllaceous corolla. In this, the petal shape is like that the petal of Crucifera with a difference. The difference is the one part is narrow, one part is wide, and it is at right angle, but its margin are serrated and the number is 5. So if we see this flower, this type petals which are visible to us. So the serrated margin are there, number of petals is 5, and in cruciform the margin is smooth and the number of petals is 4. The third is known as rosaceous. Rosaceous again found in the rose family members. Here the number of petals is in multiples of 5, and every petal has a narrow base and then it is widened towards the top. We have all seen the rose petals. So this type of corolla would be called rosaceous. Clear? Next, the fourth one is known as papilionaceous corolla. And as the name tells us, it is the characteristic feature of Papilionaceae family. All the members of Papilionaceae family would have this type of corolla. Here the number of petals is 5 and their arrangement is also very peculiar. One petal is at the top part, which is called posterior part. So this is one petal, it is single and it is biggest petal. It is known as standard. The margins of this petal is exposed. The next two petals are in pair and they are smaller. These two petals are known as wings, and other two petals are the anterior most and are the smallest, and these two are also fused. So we see a loop like structure there between them. They are known as keels. So the arrangement is that the posterior petal standard is the largest and its two margins are exposed. Then there are two more petals, that is these are in pair, and they have one margin in and one margin out, and the last two, that is the anterior two petals, are smallest. They are fused to form a boat like structure and they are known as keels. So this arrangement is known as Papilionaceous arrangement of petals, characteristic feature of Papilionaceae. Clear? Now we will talk about different forms of gamopetalous corolla. Okay, so the first one is tubular corolla. As the name tells us, what exactly the arrangement is going to be like? Here the petals are going to be fused to form a tube-like structure. So these are the sepals and petals are fused to form a narrow tube-like structure. This type of corolla is seen in the disc floret of sunflower. Okay, next type is campanulate. Here the corolla is bell-shaped, which is found in campanula. The third one is infundibulum or funnel-like. So again, petals are fused, but instead of tube-like structure, it makes a funnel-like structure. This type of corolla is found in Datura. One more is known as rotate. Here the petals are also fused and it is wheel-shaped corolla. This is seen in case of a Brinjal, Calotropis, etc. Next one is hypocateriform corolla or salver-shaped corolla. Here corolla tube becomes hypocateriform long and it bears expanded flat limbs, which is found in case of Musanda, Ixora, Vinca, etc. Another type of corolla is unciolate. Here the corolla is unshaped. For example, Bryophyllum. Next, one more is known as bilabiate. Here the sepals and petals are fused to form leaves like structure. So it appears as an upper leaf and a lower leaf. So it is known as bilabiate. It is found in Salvia and Osimum. The next type of corolla is known as ligulate corolla. Ligulate corolla is tongue like corolla. Again, the petals are fused, but All of them fuse to form a strap-like or tongue-like structure. So, this is seen in ray floret of sunflower. In sunflower, that yellow structure which is visible to us towards the periphery is actually the ligulate corolla. That means all the petals are fused to form a tongue-like or strap-like structure. Next, another one is known as personate corolla. In personate corolla, here the corolla also bilipped, but its mouth is closed due to tightly placed leaves of corolla, which is seen in case of Antirrhinum, that is dog flower. Clear? So these are the various forms of corolla. Next, now we will talk about aestivation. So aestivation is the arrangement of inner holes of sepals and petals when it is in the form of a bird. So in a floral bird, how the sepals are arranged in their circular hole manner and how the petals are arranged, that is known as aestivation. So arrangement of sepals and petals in a bird condition is known as aestivation. And here when we talk of classification, the first one is known as velvet aestivation. So in velvet aestivation, the petals or sepals, they come closer to each other end to end. There is no overlapping of margin. So if you see the sepals showing the velvet aestivation, there are 5 sepals with their pointed end. And if it was a petal, we should use this concave shape. So this is known as velvet aestivation, where there is no overlapping of margin. And this type of arrangement is seen Brassica or Crucifera family. This is the most common arrangement of sepals and petals which we see. One more example is Calotropis. Here we also find the velvet arrangement. Okay, the second arrangement is known as twisted aestivation. In twisted aestivation, one margin is in or overlapped and the other margin overlaps. We write it as in and out. So in all of these sepals, one margin is in and out, in and out, then in and out. So this type of arrangement of petals or sepals is known as twisted aestivation. And this is again a very characteristic feature of Malvaceae family. So we see it in China rose, okra, gossypium. So these are some important flowers in which twisted aestivation is found. Okay. The third type of arrangement is known as imbricate aestivation. In imbricate aestivation, there are 2 types. One is ascending imbricate, other one is known as descending imbricate. So in ascending imbricate, it is the anterior one which is present completely out, that is both the margins are completely exposed. One petal is present completely in, both the margins are completely overlapped and other 3 are present in and out. So one completely in, one out and 3 in and out. This is ascending imbricate. In descending imbricate, it is also known as vaxillary aestivation. This we have already talked of when we are talking of papilionaceous corolla. In papilionaceous corolla, the posterior most corolla is the outermost and it's known as standard. There are 2 lateral petals which are smaller in size with one margin in and one margin out. And there are very small 2 anterior petals which are fused. So this arrangement is known as descending imbricate. In descending imbricate, the posterior sepals or petals is going to be out. That means both the margins are out. But most of the time when we talk of imbricate aestivation, then we are actually referring to the ascending imbricate. But there is a difference. So if you write only imbricate, 1 in, 1 out and 3 in and out. If you write ascending imbricate, anterior one out, any one in and 3 in and out. But in case of descending imbricate, there is no variation. It has to be in this manner only. Posterior is completely out, the 2 laterals are in and out and small keels are completely covered. So this simple imbricate is seen in गुलमोहर एंड डिसेंडिंग इम्ब्रिकेट इज सीन इन पी और पैपिलियोनेसियस फैमिली. क्लियर. नाउ वी विल कम टू द फोर्थ टाइप, दैट इज क्विंकेंशियल एस्टिवेशन. इन क्विंकेंशियल एस्टिवेशन टू आर इन, टू आर आउट एंड वन इन एंड आउट. सो दिस इज द अरेंजमेंट विच इज सीन इन क्विंकेंशियल एस्टिवेशन एंड दिस इज सीन इन केस ऑफ रैनुनक्युलस, गुआवा एक्सेट्रा. सो एज आई सेड इन द बिगनिंग, दिस अरेंजमेंट्स आर कॉमन फॉर बोथ सेपल्स एंड पिट. ऑल द टाइम दे आर अरेंज्ड इन ए सर्कुलर मैनर विच वी कॉल्ड होल. इन वेलवेट देर इज नो ओवरलैपिंग ऑफ मार्जिन. इन केस ऑफ ट्विस्टेड एस्टिवेशन वन मार्जिन इज इन, वन मार्जिन इज आउट. इन इम्ब्रिकेट देर आर टू टाइप्स बट देर आर थ्री डिफरेंट टर्म्स. ओनली इम्ब्रिकेट वन इन वन आउट एंड थ्री आर इन एंड आउट. असेंडिंग इम्ब्रिकेट विल हैव एंटीरियर वन कंप्लीटली आउट, एनी वन इन एंड थ्री इन एंड आउट. इन डिसेंडिंग इम्ब्रिकेट द पोस्टीरियर वन विच इज कंप्लीटली आउट, टू लैटरल इन एंड आउट, टू एंटीरियर आर स्मॉल एंड कंप्लीटली एनक्लोज्ड. इन क्विंकेंशियल अगेन फाइव पेटल्स आर फाउंड, टू आर कंप्लीटली इन, टू आर कंप्लीटली आउट एंड वन इन एंड आउट. सो दिस इज द अरेंजमेंट ऑफ सेपल्स और पेटल्स. दिस इज द वे दे आर अरेंज्ड ऑन द रिसेप्टिकल और थैलेमस. क्लियर. नेक्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट एंड्रोशियम, द मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट ऑफ द फ्लावर. So don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon for more updates. Thank you.